Happy Pride Month! Queens Public Library continues its ongoing commitment to promote queer liberation and representation across our borough and beyond. We will be highlighting LGBTQ+ titles, including banned books, sharing knowledge and stories through our programming, and so much more. Everyone is welcome at Queens Public Library, and we are here for you. For more information, visit queenslib.org/pride22. Summer reading kicks off this month. Visit summerreading.queenslibrary.org for our full summer reading program schedule, book lists for all ages, and other resources to keep your kids engaged and learning all summer long. Juneteenth celebrates the end of slavery in the United States. Check out our reading lists and join us for in-person and virtual programs to learn more about this important day in U.S. history. Visit our website for more information. The best way to fight book banning is to read banned books. We are joining forces with Brooklyn Public Library and the New York Public Library to take a stand against censorship with the NYC Banned Books Challenge. 10 banned or challenged books that expert librarians recommend New Yorkers borrow and read. Visit our website to learn more.
Okay, sorry. Let's start over again. Sorry. First sign I'm going to teach you is sorry. My technology is not so great. Welcome. I'm happy that you are joining me today. If this is the first time you join me, I hope you'll enjoy and learn and be inspired to learn American Sign Language. I am a storyteller, and I'll tell stories with my voice and American Sign Language. And we begin by saying hello. How do you say hello? Hi, happy that you're here. And we have to really, first thing we have to do is warm up our hands because we're going to talk with our hands. So clap 10 times and wake them up. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Now, this show is for young children and their parents, mothers, fathers, aunts, uncles, for the whole family. And I know that many of you know the ASL alphabet, but we're going to sing and sign it just to get us warmed up, okay? Take the dominant hand that you write with and rest it on your other arm like this. So you don't want to be bobbing up and down. And we're going to sing. Now don't worry if you can't keep up with me. Just sing with me and watch the finger spelling. And when you're alone, you can practice. And the best way to practice your alphabet is to look in a mirror and go A, B, C. Practice by looking in the mirror. And just know that people who are looking at you signing, they see A, B, C, but be mindful that what you see is this. When I sign, I see A, B, C. So you see, you have to just practice, and practice makes perfect. And the best way to practice the ABCs is to begin with easy words that rhyme, that sound the same. So I'm going to show you the A, which is take your palm, put your fingers down, and there is A right there, A. And then you put your fingers up and put your thumb in, and that's a B. So you know the A, you know the B. And now A, B, and this is a C. Look, see, it kind of looks like a C, right? A, B, C. So I'm going to jump up to the letter in the alphabet at the other end, the T. Why? I'll tell you why. Take your fingers, take your thumb, and put it between your pointer finger and your middle finger. And that's a T. So in sign language, this is a T. And if you make a T with two hands, this is the sign for toys. Toys. We're going to play today, but I'm not going to use toys. I'm going to use my hands. So this is A, B, C. And I just showed you the T. So now you know the T, you know the A, and you know the B. So if you say B-A-T, that spells what? Bat. B-A-T. Well, you know the C, and if you go C-A-T, that spells what? Cat. So you see how easy it is? This is cat, C-A-T. And this is S-A-T is sat, or sit. So that's how I suggest that you practice the ASL alphabet. Don't try to go to A, B, C. We'll do it now, but practice short, short words that rhyme, that sound the same, and you'll get it. Practice makes perfect. Okay. So it's A, B, C, D, E, E, F, G. Do that again. A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H. See the H? And then swing your hand and put up the I. J, another K. This is three. Put your thumb up there in between the V and A, B, C, D, T. So you know the T. So it's C, A, T. And B, A, T. And S, A, T. So you see how that finger spelling works. But let's go through the whole alphabet, and then I'm going to tell you some stories, and then you will learn the signs as you watch me tell you stories. And mostly, I hope to inspire you to continue learning ASL. It's a beautiful language. And I'm going to take a sip of water. Okay, you ready? Just follow along with me or just sing with me, but watch me as I sign the alphabet. A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K, L, M, N, O, P, Q, R, S, T, U, V, W, X, Y, and Z. Now you know your A, B, C. Next time, won't you sign with me? Again, A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K, L, M, N, O, P, Q, R, S, T, U, V, W, X, Y, and Z. Now you signed your ABCs, and next time, maybe you'll sing with me. So there you go. Clap, pat yourself on the back, and just remember, practice makes perfect. So don't get frustrated. How do you like that sign for frustrated? Frustrated is like you're hitting yourself up against the wall. Frustrated. So you, and I know you're going to wonder, oh, I have to remember that sign. Don't worry about it. Stay with me and move along. Don't be thinking about the sign you just saw and miss when I'm signing the next. So it's very complicated, but you'll get it. You'll get it. I'm going to start off with singing a song that we teach little children. And because we have to isolate our hands, our hands are an instrument of expression. So put your hands behind your back and let's sing. But I have to sign, so I can't have both hands. So it's, where is Thumpkin? Where is Thumpkin? Here I am. Here I am. And now, how are you this morning? Very well, I thank you. Run away. Run away. And then what's next? Pointer. Where? I'm going to point with the pointer. Where is Pointer? Where is Pointer? Here I am. Here I am. How are you this morning? Very well, I thank you. Run away. And then middleman is not so easy to do. Where is middleman? Where is middleman? Here I am. Here I am. How are you this morning? Very well, I thank you. Run, hide, run and hide. Now ringman is a challenge to put up by yourself. Where is ringman? Where is ringman? Here I am. Here I am. Oh, I did it. How are you this morning? Very well, I thank you. Run and hide, run and hide. Now, pinky is easy. Here we go. Where is Pinky? Where is Pinky? Here I am. Here I am. How are you this morning? Very well, I thank you. Run and hide, run and hide. And where are all of them? Here they are. And we are now going to do some storytelling using ASL, American Sign Language. And the last few times I'm with you, I usually teach you a song that includes a little finger spelling. And some of you may remember that I taught you the story song about a dog or a dog. In California, they sign dog like this, dog, ear here. In New York and in the Bronx, where I was working, we signed dog. We'd slap our thigh and I go, come on, dog. That's the sign we use for dog. But it doesn't matter. The important thing is for people to understand what you're trying to say, right? You understand? See, that's the sign for understand. Understand. Now I can see, ask you, I can do a whole sentence. Do you understand? Yes or no? Or I could just use my face and one sign. I could say, understand? Ah, you understand. You see how that works? Facial expression. I'm trying to say. So let's do instead of bingo, which we did with B-I-N-G-O, today I'm going to take you to a farm. Now, the sign for farm, F-A-R-M, is farm. Because someone told me, because on a farm, a farmer usually has a beard. So this became the sign for farm. Now, for person, if I'm talking about a farm, I will tell you where it is. A farm over there, or maybe my farm is over there. You point and you said that's how we set up. So if we were talking about a farm, every time in the beginning, I'd set it up and I'd say farm, where? There. And I would point to it. So today, you will probably know this is Old MacDonald. Old MacDonald. But I don't know. I've been thinking about it. I don't think that the farmer was so old, but it's an expression, O-L-E, Old MacDonald. So forget the O, and we're going to give him a name sign, MacDonald. How's that? When you don't know a person, you put it over the heart. This is an M, MacDonald. I'm going to say O. So Old MacDonald. Now, I've already said it, so we don't have to do this again. We'll say, Old MacDonald had a farm. And now we're going to practice the letters E, I, E-I-O, right? So now you're going to, by the finish of the song, you're going to go E-I-E-I-O. Okay, let's go from the top. There was a farmer had, no, that's the wrong song. Sorry, this is a sign for mistake. We're going to do Old MacDonald. Old MacDonald, over there, had a farm. Now, E-I-E-I-O. On the farm, he had a cow. Now the sign of the cow. This is the letter Y, make the N, the cow. And on the farm, he had a cow. with a moo moo here and a moo moo there. Their moo, everywhere a moo moo. And now we get all McDonald had up. Next, a horse. Take the L and the two U's. This is horse, make the ears. So we have cow and we have horse. So old McDonald had a farm. E-I-E-I-O. Oh, Barbara can sign with two hands. And on the farm he had a horse. E-I-E-I-O. With a nay nay here and a nay nay there. Here a nay, there a nay, everywhere a nay nay. Old McDonald had a farm. E-I-E-I-O. And on the farm he had a duck. Who doesn't know what a duck is? Quack, quack. So old McDonald had a farm. E-I-E-I-O. And on the farm he had a duck. E-I-E-I-O. With a quack, quack here and a quack, quack here. There a quack, everywhere a quack, quack. Old McDonald had a farm. E-I-E-I-O. What other animal would he have had? A pig? Oh, oink, oink. So it's old McDonald had a farm. E-I-E-I-O. And on the farm he had a pig. E-I-E-I-O. With a oink, oink here and an oink, oink there. There an oink, everywhere an oink, oink. Old McDonald had a farm. E-I-E-I-O. I like to sign with both hands, but not everybody can do that. E-I-E-I-O. And let's go. So we had a cow, he had a cow, he had a horse, he had a duck, and a pig with an oink, oink, oink. And we'll ask only one more. He also had a frog. Take a letter. This is a three. Like frog. Like he's jumping. Frog. And on the farm, he had a frog. E-I-E-I-O. Now, what is a frog? What's the sound a frog makes? You know that. A ribbit, ribbit, ribbit. With a ribbit, ribbit here and a ribbit, ribbit there. Here a ribbit, there a ribbit, everywhere a ribbit. All McDonald had a farm. E-I-E-I-O. Now let's do all the animal sounds in one row after we finish the opening line. Old McDonald, he had a farm. E-I-E-I-O. With a moo here and a nay nay here and a oink oink here and a quack quack here. You got the idea. That's how you learn. Repeat again and again. So that's our first song today. Not bingo. We have Old McDonald and E-I-E-I-O. E-I-E-I-O. Yay! Pat yourself on the back and Barbara's gonna have another drink of water. Oh, by the way, I haven't shown you my name sign yet. In the world of sign language communication, people have name signs. And of course, you know, you see my name on the bottom, it's Barbara, B-A-R-B-A-R-A. So when I introduce myself to the deaf children at St. Joseph's in the Bronx, I told them that I loved books. My name was Barbara, and I spelled it B-A-R-B-A-R-A, Barbara. And my nose was always in a book. Why? Because I was like a bookworm, I told them. You know, my nose in the book, and I'm always reading. I'm a bookworm. Well, the children said, Miss Barbara, we're going to give you your name sign. I said, what? They said, this is a book. You are a bookworm. So they took my letter of my name, B, and they put it by in the book and went, Barbara. And that's my name sign, Barbara. But what is my job? I'm a storyteller. This is the sign for story. And this is a person. So I'm a storyteller. I tell stories with my voice and sign language. So now I have a very funny, funny song about monkeys. Oh yeah, I think you know it. It's about five little monkeys. One, two, three. Notice the numbers. One, two, three, four, five little monkeys. Some of you know it. Five little monkeys jumping on a bed. One fell off. So here's the bed, and here's the five little monkeys jumping on the bed. And one fell off and bumped his head. Mama called the doctor. In the old days, we'd go phone, but nowadays, we don't go phone. So I tell you, you have to sign what you mean. So that first little monkey fell off the bed, bumped his head, and what did his mother do? Mother called the doctor, and the doctor said, no more monkeys jumping on the bed. Fine. Then there were four monkeys on the bed. So four little monkeys jumping on the bed. One fell off and bumped his head. Mama called the doctor, and the doctor said, no more monkeys jumping on the bed. So now there were three little monkeys jumping on the bed. One, two, three. Where on the bed? Some people sign bed this way. Some people sign bed this way. You have to be flexible. Doesn't matter. You understand what I'm saying. So three little monkeys jumped on the bed. One fell down and bumped his head. Mama called the doctor, and the doctor said, no more monkeys jumping on the bed. So do we have two monkeys on the bed? Two little monkeys jumping on the bed. One fell off and bumped his head. What did Mama do? Mama called the doctor. And the doctor said, no more monkeys jumping on the bed. Now we've got one little monkey on the bed. One little monkey jumping on the bed. Jumping on and fell down and bumped his head. Mama called the doctor. And what did the doctor say? The doctor said, no more monkeys jumping on the bed. So that's the story of the five little monkeys. But I think they probably still jumping on the bed from time to time. So that's another story song, a story song that I love. And you know, as a storyteller, I know many, many stories. Different parts of the world. And I have all those stories where the titles list is in my head. So I made myself, and this is a great idea for some of you out there, mothers, think fathers, think about this. I have what is called a story hat. I took one of my favorite hats and I collected all these things that remind me of all the stories, birds and spiders and butterflies. Very hard for me to hold up and sign, but I just twirl it around, and this is Barbara's story hat. And there you go. I wear it. This is my table of contents. So I suggest mothers, fathers, for the children, when you read books and they have favorite stories, get a little hat. You know, a lot of the baseball cap even, and put little items on it to help the children keep a record and remember their favorite stories. You can, if you don't have a little something to put on, just write a piece of paper and pin it on and make yourself a story hat. Why? For the fun of it. And this is the sign for fun and funny and QH. Anyway, all right, so. The last few times I was here, I told you some stories about bears, animals, like bears and the bear's toothache. Some of you remember it. But today, I'm going to tell you another one of my favorite stories about a vegetable. It's a, well, some people say it was a turnip, a T-U-R-N, turnip. I don't know the sign for turnip. There's also a story my friend tells about the great, enormous carrot. You know, this is Miss Barbara's carrot. And sign language, you go like this, carrot. Some people go, this is the sign. Well, this is about a carrot. There was a farmer and his wife, and the farmer decided that he loved carrot soup. So he planted, see the plant, he goes up, planted seeds. And every day, he watered the seeds, and he waited, and he waited, and his wife would say, did the carrot grow yet? And he said, not yet. Be patient. And every day, one day, he saw the top of the carrot come up, this orange thing, and he said, I think it's soon, and soon. And he kept watering the carrot every day. And one day, it had pushed its way up from the dirt, the top of the carrot sticking up, and the big greens were nice and getting a little wilted from the sun. So there we go. You see that? Just can't use a visual as well. And so the farmer tried to pull the carrot. And he went, oh, he pulled. But it stuck. He couldn't pull it. And he pulled, and he pulled. So he called his wife, and she said, come and help me. The carrot is stuck. I can't pull it. And so the farmer stood there. He grabbed the greens of the carrot, the top, and he pulled. And his wife put her arms around him, and she pulled him. And they pulled, and they pulled. But that carrot was stuck. So the mother called her son. He was a teenager, so he was strong. Come here, help us, help us. So the son comes running, and he grabbed his mother's waist. The farmer's wife grabbed the farmer's waist, and the three of them, one, two, three, pulled. Get it out of the earth. So the brother called his sister. She was a little younger, but she was pretty strong. And she came running. So the sister put her arms around her brother's waist. The brother put his arms around his mother's waist. His mother put her arms around her husband's waist, the farmer. And the four of them pulled. The farmer said, ready? One, two, three, pull. Ugh. That was so stuck in the ground, it wouldn't budge. Well, now what are they gonna do? So the daughter, the sister, she called her favorite, the dog, and the dog came, and the dog grabbed her apron in his teeth, around it, and the dog pulled, and the sister pulled, and the brother pulled. You've got the idea. They were all pulling, and the dog didn't do it. Then they called the cat. I don't know how the cat got a hold of that dog. Maybe somehow they did it, because you know, in a story, anything can happen. But finally, there was a little tiny mouse who was watching it all, and the mouse said, hey, maybe I can help. And they said, help, how are you gonna help? But that mouse, that little mouse, it's a mouse, came over, and he put his bit right into the cat's tail. The cat pulled, the dog pulled, brother, the sister, they all pulled, and out came that carrot. Whoa! And there they get. This is the biggest carrot Miss Barbara could find. But you got an idea. That's called the Great Enormous Carrot. My friend Margaret Yuan tells it. And she was from China, and she tells the story about the Great Enormous Carrot. And in Russia, they tell the story about that Great Enormous Turnip. So that is a story about how people working together were able to get the job done. Working together, it's all about cooperation and working together. And looking, I've also told you some of my favorite stories about turtles. Now here you go, take your cup, your hand like this, and take the A and put it underneath, and that's the sign, the turtle. And I believe the last time I told you the story about the tug of war, about a turtle who challenged an elephant and a hippopotamus to a tug of war, and the turtle one. But today, I think I'm going to tell you a story about another big animal called a beaver. Here's the sign for beaver. Make your an A sign, put your hand out, and then go like this and put the sign beaver. See that? See the beaver? So now you know the sign for beaver, sign for turtle. And the two of them lived where? In a pond, a P-O-N-D, a pond. Not a lake, but a pond, a small body of water. On one side the turtle, and the other side the beaver. And all around the pond were trees. Beautiful trees. One day, the turtle came up, and he noticed the trees were disappearing. One day, another tree, nothing, another tree. And he was confused. He said, wait a minute, who's chopping down those trees? And then he was swimming in the pond and saw beaver. And beaver had just come down, having chopped down with his teeth another tree. And the turtle said, wait a minute, are you the one who's chopping down those trees? And beaver said, yes, I had to make my home here under the pond. But how could you do that? This is my pond. Oh, the beaver said, I don't think so. I was here first. This is my pond. Turtle said, oh, no, I don't think so. And they were arguing. Finally, the turtle had an idea. He decided to challenge the beaver to a race. A race. Turtle said, beaver, let's start on this side of the pond, and I'm going to count to three, and we're going to have a race, a competition. Whoever gets to the other side of the pond first, we'll get to stay in the pond and call it their own. The beaver said, you want to, to the turtle, you want to have a race with me, the beaver? Everyone knows that I'm the fastest swimmer in the pond. Turtle, he said, oh yeah, I challenge you to a race. We'll get to the other side of the pond before you do. Beaver laughed. Okay, fine. Beaver said, was so sure that he was going to win. He said, I'll give you a head start. You go first. I'll just wait for you. You go first. Turtle said, are you sure? Yes. Wait a minute. So Beaver said, you really challenging me? You want me to go first? The turtle said, yes, you go first. I will get to the other side before you. I'm sure of that. Beaver laughed and he said, okay, fine. So Beaver jumped into the water. And as he started to swim, turtle very carefully. No, the beaver has a long tail, right? A big fat tail. Turtle put his teeth gently into the beaver's tail and held on. And the beaver was swimming. Every once in a while, he looked over his shoulder and he'd laugh. Turtle kept going. And Turtle, as they got close to the other side, Turtle looked, and just as Beaver was about close to the end of the pod, the edge of the pond, Turtle put his plan in action. He bit into the tail. Beaver felt it and up flipped his tail up and flung the turtle, who landed right out at the edge of the other side of the pond. And as Beaver came up and Beaver saw a turtle, he said, how did you do that? Turtle said, I told you that I would get before you. So that's how Turtle outwitted Beaver. But I like to think that they decided that they were friends and they were going to continue living together side by side in the pond as good friends. And they did, which reminds me of a song. Barbara always thinks of song. There's a wonderful song that was written in 1929, I think it was, and it's called Side by Side or Together. And the name of the song is Side by Side, but I like to sing together. And I always ask my audience, how many of you have a lot of money? I don't have a lot of money. So the first line of the song is, oh, we ain't got a barrel of money. It's an idiom, a lot of money. So nothing money. So that's how we signed the first one. Shake your head, but look a little sad. Oh, we ain't got a barrel of money. Do you see? You have to sign what you mean. The American English has a lot of idiomatic expressions. So you've got to sign what you mean. You can say the idiom, but you've got to sign what you mean. So we're going to do that from the top. We're going to learn this because this happens to be Barbara's favorite song because it tells a lot about the world today, that we're all in this together. So from the top, oh, we ain't got a barrel of money. No, stop. This is the fun stuff. Maybe. The next line is maybe we're ragged and funny. Ragged, I sign that meaning poor. So this is the sign I use for ragged because, you know, when someone's poor, sometimes their sleeves are torn. So for me, this is how I sign it. So it's, oh, we ain't got a barrel of money. Maybe we're ragged and we use for funny. This is an H, and you have to know it's funny. Isn't that a funny sign for funny? Funny. Okay. Oh, we ain't got a barrel of money. And this is maybe, this maybe. Maybe we're ragged and funny, but we'll travel along. Everybody make a V, crook your finger like that, and skate it up like that. That's a sign for travel. We'll travel along. How? Singing a song, and we're going to say side by side, but we're going to sign together. Whoa, let's do it from the top one more time. The title, Side by Side, together, side by side. Now, oh, we ain't got a barrel of money, maybe. Be we're ragged and funny, but we'll travel along, singing a song, side by side. Oh, that was wonderful. I wish I could see you, but I can't. So I can only imagine that you're following along with me. And maybe you'll, if you're not watching today, you'll catch me on Facebook, because this video will be up and you can watch me again and again and practice some sign language, because my job here today is to inspire you to want to learn about sign language, American sign language, and inspire you to tell, love and tell stories. So let's go one more time from the top. Oh, we ain't got a barrel of money. Maybe we're ragged and funny, but we'll travel along, singing a song, side by side. Pat yourself on the back. Let's just see how we're doing. Okay. So today we talked about the five little monkeys. We sang that song. We did the ABC song and the E-I-E-I-O, old McDonald's. And I'm trying to think of another story to add. Oh, and I did the story about the great enormous carrot. And that was about cooperation, people working together. And just because I love this story, and I told it before, I'm going to tell it to you again. It's about a little boy who was very brave. He lived in a little house at the edge of a forest. He was so brave. And one night he went to bed, the windows open. It was a hot summer night. His mother and father said goodnight to him, good night. And he pulled the covers up and he was just about to fall asleep when he heard a sound. Oh! He jumped up and sat up. What was that? He wasn't sure he heard anything. And just then he heard it again. Whoa! Something or someone was crying. So I told him the boy was brave. He jumped out of bed. Walked over the window where he heard the noise, and he looked. Sitting under the window was a big brown bear. The bear was holding his paw on his jaw and cried, "Oh, my tooth is loose, and I can't pull it out." The little boy said, "What? What did you say? You have a loose tooth?" "Yes, but my paw, see, I can't grab it." So the boy said, "Well, maybe I can help you." The bear said, "You think you can, maybe? Can you help me?" The boy said, "Sure, but you have to be quiet, shh." So the boy raised the window all the way up, and the bear, up on his, grabbed it, and he climbed up and fell into the room. The little boy said, "Shh, my mother and father are sleeping. You don't want to wake them up." He said, "Okay, I have an idea. Let me see." And the bear opened his mouth. Whoa! But it was dark in there. So the little boy went under his bed, picked up a flashlight, and he said, "Okay, open your mouth again." And the boy shone the light in, and way in the back was this tooth hanging. So the boy said, "Okay." He told the bear with his paw to hold the light, shine in it, and the little boy put his foot up on the thigh of the bear and reached in and grabbed the tooth and pulled and pulled, but that tooth stuck. Oh, ho. The boy said, "That's not going to work. I have another idea. Why don't you sit on the bed and you put your paws over here? Catch it, and I'll hit you on the head with a lamp. And maybe it'll fall out." Well, children always laugh when I tell that line. So the bear said, "Okay." He sat on the bed, and he put his hand here ready to catch the tooth. The little boy picked up the pillow, and he whacked him on the head. And the lamp fell, but the tooth didn't fall out. And then the boy heard his father say, "What's going on out there?" Oh. The boy told the bear, "Hide fast." Well, the bear was so big, he went under the boy's bed, but the bed raised way up and up. "Oh, that's not going to work." So the bear jumped up, went into the closet, and he stood like this. Sorry, I didn't close the door. His father walked in the room. He said, "What's going on here?" The boy said, nothing, Dad. I just knocked the lamp fell off the table. Sorry. Go back to bed. Everything's okay." Well, the father went back to his room, said, "Go to sleep. Come on, school tomorrow." The boy said, "Okay, Dad." So then the boy went to the bear. He said, "Okay, this is it. We got to get this tooth out. You got to be out of my house fast, because my father's coming back." So the little boy remembered something he had seen in a book. So maybe it was a TV show. He went under his bed and pulled out a long string. He said to the bear, "I'm going to tie it around the tooth that's hanging. And I'm going to go over to the window. I'll go over to the door and hold it. And then when I say 1, 2, 3, jump, jump. You jump, I'll pull, and the loose tooth will come out."
that's going to work?
Let's wait and see what happened. So that's exactly what the bear went over to the window and he climbed up and he was holding his hand over here. Ready? And then the boy went to the other side of the room and he said, okay, one, two, three, jump. Oh, the bear jumped out of the window as the tooth flew out of his mouth. Would you look at that tooth? Whoa. The boy was a surprise. He went over to the window. The bear looked up. He said, can I see it, please? The boy took the tooth and showed it to the bear. The bear said, whoa. Huh. The boy said, would you like it? The bear said, no, I don't want it. You can have it. The bear said, thanks, kid. Bye. And the bear disappeared into the woods. The little boy took the tooth. And he got an idea. He put it under his pillow. And he went to sleep thinking, oh, if the tooth fairy comes tonight, the tooth fairy will be really surprised. And that, my friends, the story of the bear's toothache by the author David MacPhail, one of my favorite authors. So there you go, a story called The Bear's Toothache by who? David MacPhail. It's not in print anymore, so maybe you can find an old copy on Amazon or go to your library and maybe they will have a copy, because he was a wonderful, famous author from a long time ago. Well, not so long ago, but not recent. So that's another one of Miss Barbara's favorite too. So we saw the great enormous turnip. We had the bear's toothache. We're telling a lot of stories today. We told the story about the turtle and the beaver, and we still have a little more time for some more. So we're going to repeat some of the things, and I'm going to just talk about some natural signs that some of you know, like baby, book, ball, throw, drink, eat, ice cream, banana. Many, many signs are natural signs that you already know. And I'm going to encourage you to look up and go get some books on sign language, ASL. But today, on YouTube, there are so many ASL dictionary, online dictionary. Check them out. When I was teaching sign language at Queensborough Community College in Bayside, Queens, a long time ago, I spent a lot of time and a lot of money on Xerox copies for handouts. If I were teaching it today, I would give out a handout with a list of websites for people to look up, and they can see videos and learn sign language. So I know many, many hearing people really love sign language communication. So I encourage all of you to continue and see how you can learn. And also check out my Facebook posts all on from the Queens Public Library. I've done a few of these programs, and you know how much I love to tell stories. Okay. Trying to think now. I think what I'm going to do now is do the ABCs again, one more time, because it's important. I think it's really good to learn the alphabet. I know that children love to learn the alphabet. They love to communicate with one another. Okay, so it's A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K, L, M, N, O, P, Q, R, S, T, U, V, W, X, Y, F, Z. Now I know my A, B, C. Next time, won't you sign with me? Yay! Fantastic. That's fantastic. And don't forget, all McDonald, we learned the E, I, E, I, O today. And the five little monkeys jumping on the bed. And you notice when I said they call the doctor, in the old days, you would say call. But now, people don't call like this. Some people do in their homes, but we all have our trusty iPhone. So we would call like this. So that song you would change. Five little monkeys jumping on the bed and they call, mama called the doctor. And the doctor said, so it's really important to sign what you really mean and what you're saying. Okay. Now, because this happened to be my favorite song, and we're going to end with the bingo. There was a farmer, had a dog. And we're going to come on the side, and Barbara's going to say goodbye for now. Have a wonderful summer. This is the sign for summer, and have a good vacation if you're going on vacation. School's finished soon. Here in Boston area, okay? Okay. There was a farmer. What do I say? You have to put the farmer somewhere over there. There was a farmer, and he had a dog, and Bingo was his name. Oh, his name sign was B-O, because I can't go B-I-N-G-O. So his name sign is Bingo, B-O. There was a farmer, had a dog or dog. And Bingo was his name. Oh, we're going to sing it. B-I-N-G-O. B-I-N-G-O. And Bingo was his name. Oh, what's the first letter of his name? B. So now we're going to clap out the B. And we go I-N-G-O. See how you have to practice makes perfect. There was a farmer, had a dog, and Bingo was his name. Oh. I-N-G-O, I-N-G-O, and Bingo was his name, oh, B-I. So now we knocked out the I, the B, and the I. So we clapped two times, and then go N-G-O. There was a farmer, had a dog, and Bingo was his name, oh, N-G-O, E-O, N-G-O. And Bingo was his name. Oh, now we clap out the I, B, I, N, and that just leaves G, O. So let's go. All right. There was a farmer, had a dog, poor dog. And Bingo was his name. Oh, G, O, G, O, G, O, and Bingo was his name. Oh. There was a farmer, had a dog, and Bingo was his name, oh, B-I-N-G. No, we don't, now we're going to go, oh, and Bingo was his name, oh. Now, as we're about to finish the show, we're going to end with there was, and we're going to clap five times because you already know the B, the I, N, the G, and the O. There was a farmer, had a dog, or dog, and Bingo was his name, oh, ready? And Bingo was his name. Oh, well, I sure had fun today and enjoyed myself. And I hope you all have a wonderful summer. And maybe I'll see you again in the fall. In the fall, maybe. But whatever you do, have a wonderful time and be inspired. Continue to learn ASL, American Sign Language, a beautiful language. Happy that you joined me today. And don't forget, watch me on Facebook again and again and again, and you'll learn. And you know, sometimes I slip and make a slip of the hand, and not always. The most important thing is to communicate. What are you trying to communicate? Always. And I'll say bye for now as I put on my story hat. and wish you a wonderful summer. Bye-bye, everybody.